everyone, and welcome back to my channel, Handmade by Ying with Donna. Today is October the 11th, 2022, and I'm on segment number two of the memory quilt in memory of Richard Stutler. I was able to locate this little patch that'll go along with the pillow, and it says, "This is the shirt I used to wear. When you hold it, know that I am there." And this will adhere to this after I get the interfacing on for this one shirt. So I'll be moving along. I'll do the one shirt, then I'll do the center of the quilt, and then I'll move on to the stack that I have next to me. You'll hear music play throughout the video while I'm doing it, and then the next segment that you'll see is me following up where I'm going to be measuring out and deciding what size these shirts need to be trimmed down to, and if they're going to be multiple sizes or one size. So I'll see you back at the end. Thank you. God bless and have a great day. All right, we're getting ready to start the last and final one, and this is number 38. So let's layer flat and make sure that I've got marked here exactly where I need to be at the top of the ironing board. Flatten it out. Flip the interfacing on. And you just bring it straight up to the tip. Bring it down and fold in both sides to make sure that if there's a logo showing, you're picking it up. And then check the bottom. And it just double check. That gets everything there. Double check the top. And it's picked up on every section. I'm laying this down so I don't scorch the interfacing, but sometimes it doesn't pick up everything. So just give it a little bit of heat love and it tacks it in. And when this one's finished, this will conclude this video. And the next one that you see will be me trimming them down, squaring them down to the right sizes that they're going to need to be. But I'll measure up a few, contact the family to see the exact size that they'd prefer. There's two different sizes I'm thinking that would work great. But you don't know until you get the shirts. You can do this with a heat press, but I like to do it this way. That way I can see what I'm doing. And I'm not scorching the logos. Everybody does them the way that they prefer. This one's tacked in and see a little tiny bubble there. I just want to make sure, not that it's going to matter because all this is going to be quilted in. But I just like to make sure that it's tacked good and tight, especially around the edges. And then I fold them with the interfacing in, trying to catch the logo on the outside. So when I'm squaring them up, it's easy for me to see which ones I want to start together. I marked a couple of them throughout the video that has large logos so that I'll see how the family wants me to proceed with those. With that being said, thank you for joining me on this video and God bless you. And I'll see you in the next vlog.